Good morning, guys. What is going on? Unite the Clans here, back in your life with some life in the woods, renaissance, and life is beautiful. Take a look at that sunrise. Guys, we, if you are brand new to this series, are on an endless journey westward. In Life in the Woods Renaissance with Sildur Shaders, taken in probably the most beautiful Minecraft version of Minecraft of all time. And to continue our journey, we are gonna need a boat. So that is my immediate priority. And guess what? I'm ready to go. I'm prepped. I'm ready. Hi, fishy. You look cute. And I guess we got another boat. So let's throw that in there. Let's try and clear up the inventory ever so slightly. Get the bow on the bar. And I guess we ain't got a shovel. That's right. We'll worry about that in the future. Let's try this. Tell me if I look scary. Oh, my beard shows through. Okay, that doesn't work too well, does it? So let's get rid of that. I don't know where we picked that up. And let's ride. Let's ride hard. Okay, guys, let's do this. So in this series, it's about the easiest one I currently have to record. We just go. We talk, or I talk at least. And I've been hoping... Before I started this series, it was something that had been on my mind for a while, because I'm a fan of Kurt J. Mack and Farlands or Bust, which is about as iconic as a Minecraft Let's Play can get. He's been doing it for a very long time and has traveled a very long distance. Now, when I stumbled on Life in the Woods, the idea to do this Walk-a-Thon style series, it came to me, and... I don't intend to cover anywhere close to the distance Kurt has, and I don't intend to be nearly as prolific, whatever it is, creeping up towards 400 episodes. I'm sure I'm never going to get there, guys. I want to do new things all the time, so we certainly probably won't see 400 of these, but you never know, I suppose. We're 11 deep, if I'm not mistaken. This is episode 11 for us. And the thing that I always liked most about Farlands or Bust is beyond the first 40 or 50 episodes, the show, the series, it stopped being about the game quite so much. And it started being about Kurt and the stuff he had to say. And I've always thought that I would have a lot to say. But I was never sure that I could just do a series like this where I just hop on and talk. Screw caving, building, whatever. I know I've done a little bit of those things in this series, but really not much at all. This has been about the journey, about the beautiful sights we see along the way, and about me just talking to you guys. We've talked about motivation and inspiration. I've talked about politics. Last episode, I just did a channel update, basically. And I think that's probably what this series is going to be in the future. Not channel updates, but it's going to be me just talking. I'm gonna hop on, and oh wow, we got a whale. How cool is that? When I tell you this is the prettiest version of Minecraft you've ever seen, I mean, that shows it right there. We got the only thing that I don't love about this series is we've had to mess with some of the graphics to try and get this mod pack to run smoothly. If you guys haven't tried Life in the Woods, it is the easiest thing to install. It's basically like you download another game, install it. When you want to play it, you just double-click. It's got its own icon. It's got its own launcher. And it's got its own save games and picture files. Everything. It's basically like a separate version of Minecraft. And it's been pretty great so far. We've seen a lot of biomes along the way, but I know there's some we haven't seen. And the other amazing thing about this game is that it has some mega structures, some mega builds that are filled with loot, with treasures, and with stories. And it's cool that some of the people that have started to tune into this series aren't just fans of mine, but are fans of Life in the Woods and have become fans of mine along the way. For me, the journey that goes along with this channel, the journey of trying to become a full-time video creator and Let's Player, is one I'm really enjoying, and I'm learning a lot along the way. And I had hoped when I started my channel that the game that would give me the biggest push was Minecraft, but I think, to be honest, starting a channel in the end of 2014, like a week before 2015, I think I might have missed that opportunity. It's yet to be determined, and I don't plan on going away from Minecraft, but for me, it's been very hard to find ways to break through to new viewers in Minecraft, and the only game of late that I've really figured out how to do that in is Ark Survival Evolved. So I'll ask you guys, if you're watching this series, if you're watching my Too Crafty Minecraft series or Building with UTC before that, go watch some of my Ark stuff. If it's not a game you think you like, go watch it for me. Go watch it to listen to me talk and to tell you guys stories, because I definitely do that, or to watch me build, because all the building I'm doing these days is in Ark. I think that game is new enough and fresh enough that it's sort of like the new Minecraft for a lot of YouTubers. If they can kind of figure out something that hasn't been done yet, like Kurt did with Farlands or Bust, there's a big way to break through, and there's a big way to find lots and lots of new people. I haven't found lots and lots yet, but I've found more than I have with Minecraft. And I've considered the possibility that I might at some point try and do Ark 7 days of the week, but I'm not ready for that yet, especially because of this series. Too Crafty is brand new, and those videos are doing a little better than my solo building series, but it's not quite in the league of my Ark videos in terms of views. And I could see myself, you know, walking away from just vanilla Minecraft at some point, but I'm finding it so hard to walk away from this, guys. We're down to 1 day a week with this, which I'm cool with. It's hard to find half an hour of stuff to talk about without the distraction of the game. I mean, you've seen this the whole time, and this whole episode, we're probably 7 minutes in, something like that, and all I've done is talk not about the game. I haven't talked about trees or food or crafting or mining, any of that stuff. We have not found a major land map. Aha! I am a liar. Oh, guess my boat broke. I mean, there are things I will not miss about my Minecraft 1.7.10 when it's gone. And crappy boats is one of those things I will not miss. It's nice to play a little 1.9, and 1.10's on the way with hopefully more future additions. Things are a little choppy right now, guys, so I hope we're not walking into a crash, but I hope we can get lost in these woods here and explore a little bit. The trees here are cool. You don't see trees like that in vanilla. I mean, there's 2x2 trees that are big, but nothing like this. Nothing that's a cross shape. Oh god, I'm really getting some lag, guys. I'm gonna keep this up and try and push forward into around the 7 to 10 minute mark of this video, where we can take a break. And when I do, I'll see if I can cover some ground and come back to you with something cool in front of me. But this forest is pretty neat. I love these colorful lily pads. You see those over there, or these here? They're pretty cool. And these forests are just full of trees. Yellow elderberry. Yeah, you just get a sapling from that. I think I'm going to leave that behind. And I'll leave the boxwood behind too. I'm hoping we can stumble on a cool structure this episode or two. We had that last episode, I think. Was that last episode? Two villages and some kind of cool thing. I actually shouted out a couple of people in the last episode. It's cool that some Life in the Woods geeks are tuning in, and oh god, come on. What's happening? Poison. Nice. Okay, well, let's eat some fish sandwiches and try and recover here. That should do it, eh? Am I healing? Let's see if we got anything small to eat. Green backpack, I think? How about some of these? These berries are... I haven't figured out anything you can craft with them, so these will get us back to full health. I'll just keep munching on those while we walk, and hopefully I don't stumble into whatever the heck poison just got me there. And we're coming towards the sunset. So let's cover some ground. Let's see what lies ahead. And that's an Enderman somehow spawning out here in the middle of the day. I don't get that. Don't look at him. Oh god, it's framey. Let me see if I can push through this, guys. We're getting single digit frames at the moment. That is my biggest frustration with Life in the Woods. It is beautiful and easy as heck to install, and so full of content that it would take you a very, very long time. I know a guy Who's playing? It's actually not Life in the Woods Renaissance. I think he made a version, a sort of Renaissance version of Life in the Woods before Phedran, the original creator and the creator of this mod pack, did. Dizzy Aaron, he's been playing Life in the Woods 2, which, if I'm not mistaken, is his own mod pack. And he mostly builds, but he's hundreds of episodes. Oh no, maybe 80 plus episodes deep. And and I think it's just enough content here to keep you busy for a very long time. It's late enough that I need to think about putting back down a crafting table and making a bed. So I'm going to do that, guys. I think we are deep enough into this episode that I can take a break and show you an ad. When the morning rolls around, I'm going to start walking, and I'll come back to you when I found something particularly cool. I think I've found something, guys. A water tower? I think that's what this is. I've covered a little bit of ground, nothing too crazy, and I found a few of these little sort of mini structures with rails around them. That's cool looking. Mud bricks, I like. So this is a water tower. I don't know what's here except for this, a water barrel, and I don't know if that's something worth taking, but it really can't hurt. I think I'll leave the rest of this, but this is an example of what I was talking about. Very cool looking builds, just mixed in with nature. Alright, so off we go, guys, and I think I'm going to have another 7 to 10 minutes to talk to you today. I think I was talking a little bit about my sort of journey as a YouTuber. A year and a bit in, I started at Christmas, so a year and a half maybe in, and I'm really starting to work with some other YouTubers now, regular weekly collaborations, and in contact with a bunch of people that even that I've never had a chance to play with or record with that are doing cool things on YouTube. And the one thing I wish is that this game would stop crashing. No, I'm just kidding, but seriously, it breaks my train of thought. I'm trying to focus when it crashes on exactly what I was talking about when it does crash. But the one thing I wish, of all the people that I'm regularly getting together with and talking to who are YouTubers, is that they all had the same dream and the same optimism for that dream that I have. A few of the people that I regularly play with, I have had the opportunity to talk about their channels and their aspirations for their channels. And a lot of them are of the mind that, oh, would it be nice if my channel got big enough that I could do this full time? But that's never going to happen. I don't know if I'm crazy, if it's a pipe dream, but I'm not stopping working on this until it's my full-time job. Until this thing is big enough and enough of you guys are watching every day that not only can this pay my bills, but I can do what I want when I want. I can change... I'm going to run just because there's a skelly there. But I can do what I want when I want and have people watch and build a community of geeks. I mean, I start every video by saying, "What's up, geeks?" It's because I'm one, and I want to be proud of what it's like to be a geek. And hey, you found me. This is our pet from last time. We're going to name him... I don't know. Give me a name. All right. It's obviously a different one, but we'll take any kind of slime small enough not to hurt us as a pet, and hopefully he'll follow us across the beautiful, you know, wilderness. I'm of the mind that my channel will get big, that I'll be among those people who get to do this full time and get to do it as their job and have fans is the wrong word, but have a community of viewers who love what they do, who love their personality, the things they create, and will follow them to whatever they want to do. If I change gears and never play Ark again, or change gears and this is the last Minecraft video that ever shows up on my channel, I want people who will follow me to whatever I do next, whatever I'm passionate about. And it's not always going to be the same thing. I totally understand the tempering of your hopes, because if you get your hopes up that you're going to grow this thing to 100,000 viewers and millions of views and and it doesn't happen, that can be devastating. That could be soul crushing. And I think I'm going into this with that in mind, that if this doesn't work out, I may lose a little faith and confidence in myself for believing that it was going to work out this whole time. But I don't know. I mean, it's a dream worth chasing for me. The dream of not having a boss, not having a schedule, not having to be anywhere at a particular time unless it relates to something you love. And I love it. I love video games, and I always have. I love... How does that work? I can't remember how you harvest the pears. Let's try this. I know that'll work. It's supposed to work. Get any pears out of that? Is this not a pear tree? Chestnut. Yuck. Okay, let's get lost. Yeah, it's a dream for me that's worth chasing. If my job were playing video games and making, you know, videos about it, I think I'd be a happy guy. I don't mind what I do. I work in the restaurant industry, and I have for a long time, since college, university. And I think I could do that for a while. I mean, I really don't want to be a waiter or a bartender when I'm 40, and that's 8 or so years away for UTC. So if this channel hasn't grown that big in that 8-year span, then I guess I'll maybe have to start figuring out something else to do. I mean, maybe I could be a restaurant manager or something like that, but I just got bigger ideas for what's in my future. The 9-to-5 grind from 18 to 65 is something I have never wanted to get behind. And I went to school to be a history teacher, and the reason I think that I got out of it is I'm like, if I'm not going to love what I'm doing, and I wasn't sure I would, I can't do it until I'm 65 and hope that by 65 I get to retire and have some free time. That's just not living to me. And a lot of people are on that grind, and a lot of people look down on anybody who's not also on that grind. People want to be on teams. They want everybody to be doing what they're doing. Hi, horsey. How you doing? You're a pretty horse. Yeah, people want that. They want to say, like, well, if I'm going to be stuck sitting behind a desk for the next 40 years, I want everybody else to be. Screw that, guys. I don't care if I make less money than my friends. I don't care if I don't have as nice a house as my friends. If the way that I get there is a mindless job that I hate, but has an excellent salary and benefits, screw it. I will happily be a waiter, just getting by, paying my bills, and being a happy guy if I have the opportunity to chase a dream. And for me, that dream is this: is a YouTube channel. It's Let's Playing. It started, and I've talked about this guy and the inspiration he's provided a lot, but it started with B00O, who is a, you know, big Minecraft YouTuber, and was on the Mindcrack server, and I think he's on the Crewcraft now. And it started with him. I think the idea of Let's Plays was completely brand new to me. I'd only spent a tiny bit of time watching him, and it had started with Minecraft. I'd had a friend that said, hey, have you heard of this? I think you might like it. And I hopped on YouTube and started watching a few videos on it, and it was really just people playing. It wasn't like, here's Minecraft, here's what it's all about, here's what it was just like, I'm gonna play, and if you want to watch, you watch. And after I bought the game, it was $10, I think, when I first bought it. It's like 25 or 27 now. Oh god, we're gonna need to get a bed, guys. Shoot, let me take another quick break. I'll make a bed, and I'm gonna remember my train of thought and finish this in the morning. Good morning, guys. I was just checking to see if I was facing west, and I am, and this is called a temperate rainforest. Pretty cool. Fir quarter log. I like it. I like how this place looks. It's hilly, the trees are tall, and they got a really cool texture on them. I like the way that looks. It's just different, like... Here, let's break one. You can see every side but those two has an outer texture. It's kind of cool. But I will, I'm going to finish what I'm saying, and I got to finish it quick, guys, because time's running out on episode 11 of Life in the Woods. But yeah, I got into Minecraft, played for a while, the horse update came out, and I wanted to find a video on how to build a barn. And the first one that came up was a big reddish-looking barn from B-Dubs. And in that video, he was talking about how he was about to quit his job, his dad's whatever it was, a landscaping company or a construction company, because he needed to focus on YouTube. It was making him more money than the real job. Oh, are you coming to mess? Seriously, dude, get wrecked. I'll smite you. Get smitten. I don't think I have room in my inventory for this stuff. That's cool. I'm gonna leave it. I was watching that video, and I heard him say that, and the thought had never even crossed my mind that the people making those Minecraft videos were making enough money to pay their, not only enough money to pay their bills, but enough money that it made sense for them to quit their job to go do this full time. And that planted a seed in my brain, the seed of a dream that someday that could be what I do. And it took me, oh, I'm gonna just run because I want to finish this up, not in combat, but oh, I'm too hungry to run. Okay, let's walk, I guess. But it planted a seed in my brain, guys. And it took me a long time to actually, oh my God, that's too loud. It took me a long time to actually get around to chasing that dream. But now that I have, I can't imagine stopping. I got too much to look forward to in the future and too many great things I want to do here on YouTube and in Minecraft and in Ark and in games that haven't even been thought of yet, guys. So I guess that's it. I'm not going anywhere, and I really am desperate to find some people that have, you know, have the same passion for this dream that I do and aren't just doing this as a hobby. In fact, a few of the guys I record with on a regular basis, one of the guys I record with on a regular basis hasn't even told the people he cares about that he's got a YouTube channel. I mean, if you're really going to chase a dream like I am, you got to make it something you're proud of. And I was just telling people that I work with tonight about my channel and getting them to check it out and subscribe. And I think, I don't know, guys. I think it's one of those things. The more people that do what I do, that do what other YouTubers are doing, the more people that can be honest and open about why they're doing it and what they're hoping to turn it into, the more it's not going to be a weird thing where I tell people about it and they roll their eyes or give me a funny look. It's going to be something that's that people respect and understand, and it's just not quite there yet. Like I said, I got friends who can't even tell their friends about their channels, because I don't know why. I don't. But I'm not one of those people, guys. This is a dream for me, and I'm open about it with you and with the people I care about, and I'm not going anywhere. Like I said, I got at least 8 years to make this happen before I'm a 40-year-old waiter who needs to figure out what he's going to do for the next 25 years. Yeah, so this is it. This is a perfect example of what this series is all about. If you have watched to the end of it, guys. Oh yeah, let's get this stupid helmet off. I mean, I like it, but it's pretty stupid looking, guys. If you are brand new, I mean, you've gotten what this series is about. It's about me walking, and it's really about me talking. And if you like what I have to say, go ahead and click that subscribe button, guys. I need people to subscribe for me to accomplish what I want to accomplish here on YouTube. And if you liked it, just click the like button. It's the end of the video. Not many people are watching this deep into the video anyway. So if you are, you're the kind of person who's probably already clicked those buttons. And either way, I love you. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Unite the Clans, and this has been Life in the Woods Renaissance, episode 11. Geeks, that's it. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next episode.